Everyone's Dave here and welcome to the Puzzle Bubble VR Vacation Odyssey overview. Someone apparently goes for the longest title trophy, so definite winners. Apparently this is something not new because I was scouring the YouTube comments under the trailer and people were mentioning that it's like an old title brought back to life in VR. We have a trend on Quest that older titles are being like revamped for VR because of this new technology. Essentially that's exactly what we're gonna have with Resident Evil 4 when it's gonna release. Like a remake in terms of perception and just the gameplay that you are the actual person in charge, but the whole concept and vibe doesn't really change from the original. And I'm not mad that we have stuff like that going on, because not everyone played every game ever released. It's essentially a cool way to introduce a new generation of gamers to titles that they naturally missed out because they were not living in those times. Let's go with it. Puzzle Bubble to me seems like a shooting adventure game, maybe some sort of like an Angry Birds, Zuma, Candy Crush, all of those that I would naturally assimilate with like, you know, mobile games. Something that you play like on your commute or laying an egg in your toilet, like curious that you don't necessarily need an input and just wanna have some brain that relaxing time with games while you're doing your thing. I think this case is gonna be purely on the sentimental level, which I won't be driven at all because I've not been familiar with this universe at all, so I'll be looking pretty much on the gameplay and just how it performs. On the first glance, it's not necessarily something that interests me at all. Essentially, you see, you shoot balls to the floating piles of other balls with different colors, powers, stuff like that, and you pop the area based on whatever you wanted to achieve. Very much classic games in that style. I think what interested me the most is that there is an option of multiplayer actually, to see like other players next to you shooting out their cannons to their puzzles, so I think that's gonna be pretty interesting. If it's implemented well and like with voice chat and stuff like that, maybe that's gonna be fun. I don't really see the longevity of it, because the primary design for those stylus is to play for like 15-20 minutes, but not like couple hours, so I'm concerned that the gameplay is gonna be pretty much repetitive at some point. But I gotta say the art style for Quest title is pretty good actually, if we're talking about like the polish. Of course it looks cartoony and stuff like that, but what I'm seeing, like the details and perimeters of the balls, the weaponry and characters, they don't look rough. That's pretty much it. So even though the concept might be simple, there seems to be a good level of execution, which I can appreciate in any game. But yeah, I mean, there's not much to say it honestly, so let's just get into with the footage. Oh, we on the beach, beach. Wait, the trailer looked way better than this. The hell? To pop bubbles, match 3 or more bubbles of the same color. All bubbles are attached to the bubble core. Activate bubble core by popping bubbles until one bubble or less is left. Load bubble into the top of the grab plunger and pull back. Okay. Press face button to swap bubbles with Bob. So I guess we... Oh, there's like a story. I don't like that the main menu is like blurry. It's not like very sharp in terms of just textures and just letters. Like it's like in the distance. Like you would watch a video in 360p. The quality. Really, the trailer looked amazingly. We're talking about graphics and just the polish, but this is huge downgrade. This is a story, I guess. This is like the Angry Birds, I guess. Like with the progression system and stuff. Okay. Is this the story? Okay. We're on the beach. They were trapped by a magician. And they got a cannon. Okay, so he gives me bubbles. I load. And I shoot. Okay. Aha. Okay, that's straightforward pretty much. And okay, we just progress like that. Give me the bubble. You even like kinda have marks how many will pop when you shoot there. It doesn't seem complicated at all. Pretty much you just section the bubbles. Okay, I don't need to play more story mode, I get it, but it's nothing very interesting. Let me do the duel or whatever, quick match, I don't know. I wonder if anyone's playing, it just released, so this is, I'm pretty sure, the only time I'm gonna find anyone to see. Oh, okay, I wonder if there is voice chat. I didn't have a permission for a voice, so I don't think. Duel mode, pop the bubbles before they reach the portal. There's someone. So this is like that. Okay, and he's popping as well. Too bad there's no voice chat, like, I can see him and what he's doing, which is kinda interesting as well. I don't think I've had, like, a game that I can actually, like, in real time play with someone, like, cooperatively. Wait, it's not your car, dude. Or maybe I can help him as well? Oh yeah! That's interesting. Oh! What the hell is this? Let me sabotage him. Damn. Oh, he sends the crates as well. No. Oh, they bounce from him? Oh. Okay, well, I got it anyways. Holy hell, you have to have so many coins to just unlock at least one of it. Okay, I don't need to play more. Maybe like to see just infinite just real quick. So essentially it seems like it's the same thing from the duel. You have this portal and then it generates more bubbles, right? Okay, yeah. The thing is that I'm not driven by the sentiment or whatever. I'm just seeing how the mechanics work and just the gameplay overall. I don't see this game complex enough to justify the price point. It is 20 bucks after all, but this is not the quality that I want to get with Quest 2 and nowadays with the gameplay. Like, this is very simple. For me, no, definitely not. I expect way more in this day and age, so. I feel like the trailer was misleading as well. Maybe it was like PC VR graphics because the Quest can handle way more for sure. Like, this is not Quest 2 graphics, this is like Quest 1. So yeah, no. I'll stick with other things definitely.